Hey there, everybody. Let's make something awesome today. What do you say? For this project, I used a small piece of driftwood, a few shells, polymer clay, acrylic craft paint, and some resin. I started with a small metal file and my piece of driftwood. I used the file to just smooth out some areas and create texture in others, you know, just get it the way I wanted it. And then I decided the placement for my shells and glued them on. I then started making seaweed and a fish out of my polymer clay. Okay, so now that the fish is done, let's paint this pretty little guy. I have some color shift acrylic craft paint that I got from good old Walmart. That's what I'm using to paint this cute little guy. I have a purple to blue shift, a blue to green shift, and a red to purple. and then a black with a hint of gold. That is what all I use to paint my cute little fishy. Now the clay has been baked and it is time to start making my mold. I am just using some plastic sheeting that I bought at the craft store, cutting it and hot gluing it into place. Once that is complete and I've got everything the way I want it, I will double secure it with a rubber band and packing tape and everything else I can find to make sure that there's no leaking or anything of the sort.
Before I met you, everything was black and white. Now it's so different. Now it seems so right. Before I met you, everything was black and white, but it's so different. Now it seems so bright. You bring the color to my life. You bring the color. You bring the color to my life. You bring the color. Me feel so fine.
All right, so now I am mixing up some resin to pour. I have mixed up just a little bit of some translucent blue, and I'm going to be pouring that in first. My hope is that it will kind of provide a very subtle color in the background. We'll see.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight. If you need help, if you need help, I'll shut down the city lights. I'll lie, cheat, I'll beg and bribe to make you well, to make you well. When enemies are at your door, I'll carry you away from war. If you need help, if you need help, your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you. You're gone, gone, gone. When you fall like a statue, I'm gonna be there to catch you, put you on your feet, you on your feet. And if your well is empty, not a thing will prevent me. Tell me what you need, what do you need? I surrender on a-
All right, and now we are demolding. I totally spaced out and forgot to spray my plastic sheeting with mold release. So this was a little bit of a struggle, but, you know, it's the price you pay for forgetting the important things. Once I am finished with this, I am going to take it outside and get started sanding it down and shaping it up with my Dremel.
We'll do it for you, for you. Baby, I'm not moving on. I'll love you long after you're gone. For you, for you. You will never sleep alone. I'll love you long after you're gone. And long after you're gone, gone, gone. You're my backbone. You're my cornerstone. You're my crutch when my legs stop moving. You're my head start, you're my rugged heart.
When shaping my resin pieces, I like to start off by drawing out onto the resin with a Sharpie where I want my basic shape to be, to give a good indication of where I can just go ahead and cut off chunks of resin. And once I have removed the bulk, I will go in with different grits of sanding bits on my Dremel and remove as much as I possibly can and get the shape as close to perfect as possible.
You're the pulse that I've always needed. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, my heart never stops beating for you. A drum, my heart never stops beating for you. And long after you're gone, 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 I'll love you long after you're gone, gone, gone.
Once the messy part of the sanding and shaping is done, I go in with a small piece of sandpaper and gradually work my way down the grit, getting everything as smooth as possible. I like to use hand sandpaper for this last bit just to make sure that every single little bitty scratch has been sanded out to ensure the most shine possible.
We'll be right back.
My next step is to use buffing files and a buffing powder, and I go in and shine up the entire piece. Sometimes I will do this twice or more, depending on how much I like the shine that I come up with. If it's not as shiny as I like, I will just go up a few grits and sand out any of the scratches that are causing it to look dull and do it all again. And after it has been shined up to my likeness, it is complete. And here we have the final result. I wanted to make sure that there were some bubbles inside to keep along with the Under the Sea vibe. I didn't really get too much of the driftwood on the outside of the resin, but that's okay. I still love the way it turned out. Not exactly the way I expected, but I think it's a cute little fish. I think it turned out adorable.